I must have absolute silence. Excelsior! Oh.
Now then, Geek Files, how are we all doing?
Greetings and salutations.
Yeah.
We're joined by our first ever guest this week.
Yeah.
Some of you may recognise his voice from the Twitch streams of Tabletop Racing.
Yeah, they're taking piss out of me.
And being awesome at Smite. This is Ryan Rudy.
Alright.
He's joined us this week because we're coming up after Excelsior. We normally have the shows separately.
Yeah.
This week we have a special Comic-Con one.
Yeah.
Excelsior's going to start a bout of Comic-Cons where we're going to interview cosplayers and the events and stuff like that. And you was at Sheffield Comic-Con this week, Yorkshire Comic-Con.
I was indeed. You may see a little reference behind us.
That's what you was proudly wearing. That is an awesome suit. I do like that.
Yes.
It looks sweet.
Can even wear in it. Not in the actual suit.
No, we don't want to know. That's a different show entirely, a different channel completely.
Exactly.
That's on Pornhub or something. Those kind of videos.
Spider-Hub, sticky.
Spider-Hub is more sticky.
Sticky situation.
So yeah, we'll be doing that show later on. But this is Excelsior, and we will be doing all your movie news this week.
Yep.
And opening up with quite a big story.
Yeah, big fan of The Shield. And quite surprised to find out that Michael Jace, who plays Julian, sent down for 40 years this week.
That's a pretty big sentence.
Yes. Murdered his wife.
Couldn't pay for a divorce, or...?
Well, apparently he wasn't happy that she wanted a divorce and thought she was cheating, even though there was no evidence. Waited till she got home from taking their sons, eight years old and 5 years old, at baseball practice, shot her in the back, taunted her and then shot her in both legs.
Fuck yeah. Ouch, that is...
Yeah.
That's some serious anger there.
Yeah, that's premeditated.
Yeah, that's not kind of an argument got out of control.
No.
And a moment of madness. That is, I'm going to wait for you to get back.
Yeah.
And it's not even like, oh, I popped her in the head. He shot her in the back so that he could taunt her.
Yeah.
You can't run away from this. I'm going to have... That is some sick.
Yeah.
No wonder he got 40 years.
Yeah.
That is... That is horrible.
A bit of a sour way to start the show, but it's something that does need talking about.
Yeah, I mean, it's Shield were a fucking amazing series.
Yeah.
Absolutely loved it. And it's, like I said, it's a big story.
It's slightly out of imitating life as well, because he plays a gay character on the show that tries to get out of a marriage that he used to cover up his homosexuality.
So it's just, he read an old script and thought, we'll do that. He got away with it in show, it'll happen in life.
I enjoy if you snap look on the show. If I murder her, I can go get bummed in prison. Too far.
No. He's been the Shield, now he needs an anal shield.
Too soon.
Let's move on to one of our favourite topics.
Yeah, well, your favourite topic.
Yeah, that was quite a downer as an opener, so yeah. We'll go back to some lighter news. Ghostbusters!
Yay! Again!
This is the gift that keeps giving, because we go on every week about the show's a fucking mess and don't go see it. Just go see something else instead. It gets worse. I mean, we had the character vignettes last week.
Yeah.
And they were, you know, the Hoffman one wasn't bad.
Holtzman.
Yeah. That one wasn't bad. Everything else looked shocking.
Yeah.
This week there's 4 TV spots.
Yeah.
Have come out.
Luckily you had watched all 4, so I made you turn them off after the first one.
No, but actually to be fair, I watched all 4, and then when you came, I only showed you the second one. I'm like, you don't want to see the other 3. They're just fucking, it's the same shots, the same scenes we've seen before. Maybe a couple of extra lines in there.
Yeah.
Every single one of them has that stupid, is it a black or a female thing, line in it, which they need to fucking cut from the film, to be honest.
Yeah.
But the reason I showed you the second one is because this film just becomes more and more of a mess.
Yeah.
We had, the first trailer came out that absolutely panned.
Yeah.
Then we had a week later after that, or a couple of weeks after that, on the show we were talking about, Melissa McCarthy said, it says 30 years ago and it's not to do with that, they should take it out.
Yeah.
The second TV spot comes up with saying, The icon that defined a generation.
Yeah, has been given an upgrade.
So, is it all to do with the original?
I don't even think they know anymore.
You know, it's the first trailer had it in, but Melissa McCarthy slagged it off in it. The second trailer removed it completely.
Yeah.
And now the second TV spot has that in. You see Slimer in there. We've got the Stave Puff guy in there, the Marshmallow Man in there. how are they using that? Is the Stave Puff guy popping up as a nod to the original fans?
I have no idea.
Because the way he popped up in the original was quite cleverly done.
Yeah.
Like, whatever you think of, I'll bring it to life. And he's like, he's not dangerous.
Yeah.
That were quite funny, but this is... It's a fucking mess.
I thought they were using that whole thing to bring back... Well, to bring the logo to life. Hmm.
No, because they have the Marshmallow Man.
Yeah.
And then there's a Marshmallow Man version of the Ghostbusters logo.
Yeah.
So... Which is the bad guy? Is that one just popping up for the sake of it?
I have no idea. And to be honest, I don't really care anymore.
It's more and more of a mess. And one bit that gets me as well, which I'm going to go on a big fucking pedantic rant about now, is we hate this film. It looks shit. And that makes us misogynists.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So sexism is wrong. Sexism is wrong. We shouldn't poke fun or slag off the opposite gender just for our entertainment. That is wrong. Unless you're a woman.
Yeah.
Because in the TV spot, Linda McCarthy cock shots the Marshmallow Ghostbuster logo.
Yeah.
Shoots him right in the groin and he screams out. I don't know how, there's not there. Marshmallow Ghost, but he screams out in pain. And she's going, oh, do you like that? Well, you've just hit a man in his most vulnerable, so you make it out that he's male. You've hit him in his most vulnerable point and that's funny.
Yeah, and this is coming off of last week with Fox having to take down the billboards and apologise about Mystique getting strangled.
But
it's alright for women to do it to men in a TV spot. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can in this film and in a TV spot, it's fine to hit a bloke in his most vulnerable, painful part.
Yeah.
And that's comedy.
Yeah.
But you choke a woman in a legitimate sense that is hero versus villain, and that's promoting domestic violence.
Yeah.
So where's the fucking where's equality?
Even though the Winter Soldier can strangle Bromouth.
Yeah, we had this. What about when Hawkeye was strangling Roman off with his bow in Avengers 1?
Yeah,
but you know, it's bullshit. It's sexism goes one way, and this film is absolute wank. And whoever is involved in it, who made it and filmed it, especially Paul Feige and Melissa McGarrett, I hope you get AIDS. I hope your cats get syphilis. I hope you get AIDS, and I hope you end up doing a lifetime of fucking shitty, shaky weighty commercials. I hope that's where your career ends up, because you are absolute fucking pricks.
Is this a new hashtag? Ace cats for Ghostbusters.
Yeah. No, syphilis cats for Ghostbusters. I want them to get AIDS.
Yeah.
I want them to get AIDS, and I want their cats to get syphilis.
I think the word upgrade's just a big insult to the original film as well.
Yeah. No, this is going to be nice guy, I'm going to get upgraded.
Yeah.
Yeah. As to say, well, we're going to make this one better than the original.
Yeah,
that's what it says to me. The word upgrade is better.
It's not getting upgraded. It is getting shit on from a very great high, dragged through a litter tray, and then fucking regurgitated. It is in no way an upgrade. It is.
No.
You are taking every great piece of that original and fucking attacking it with a sledgehammer.
Yeah.
You only have to look at the Marshmallow Man and Slimer. They're awful.
They are. They're fucking horrible.
They're awful.
You only see like a second of the Marshmallow Man.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it looks like they've just fucking photoshopped him from the cartoon.
Mm. Oh, God.
It looks fucking terrible.
When I saw it, it just reminded me of an ice cream man's just sort of pooped him out.
Yeah, that's the Ghostbuster logo, isn't it? Yeah. The Ghostbuster logo marshmallow thing.
Yeah.
Just looks like a white turn emoticon.
Yeah. Yeah.
His head just looks like a fucking ice cream cone on a fucking turn emoticon. It's fucking horrible. It's ridiculous. And another thing I want to put out about as well, is this supposed to be women and supposed to be role models and creating like strong positive role models for young girls. Right? In Avengers Age of Ultron, not Age of Ultron, sorry, Civil War.
Yeah.
In Civil War, Scarlet Witch accidentally blows up a corner of a building.
Yeah.
And the whole film deals with her remorse over that and the consequence of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right? Melissa McCarthy purposely blast the fucking building so the explosion hits the Marshmallow Ghost logo in its face.
Yeah. Is it going to steal all over again?
Yeah, it's like, you know, Civil War, they address the fact, collateral damage, and they address the fact and the pain and the conflict that Scarlet Witch has to deal with the repercussions of that. Miss McCarthy, bam, fuck a building up, we don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
It's alright, if anyone has a go at me for blowing up, I'll call them a misogynist.
Yeah.
I'll get a dumb phone operator who's male to sort it out.
Yeah. The hunky male that's only there is eye candy to sort it. You know. Fucking horror, I hate this film. You just don't see it. I'm thinking about creating a campaign where any cinema that shows it gets set on fire. The only way to cleanse something properly is to cleanse it with fire.
We should just set fire.
Just burn it with fire and then salt the earth and build a cinema there in 5 years' time.
Make sure it's
bonfire.
Yeah,
it can't be a female fire. No.
But let's cheer up a bit now.
It's an upgrade. They call it an upgrade and it's not. What is an upgrade? And I've been angry time on the show, which he thinks it isn't. Is Peach Dragon.
Yeah. I've just seen the trailer this morning. Mm. Beautiful.
It's the story seems to be changed quite a bit.
Yeah. I mean, I think we said the other week we just watched Jungle Book.
Yeah.
The live action Jungle Book, and that was brilliant. And this looks as though Disney are carrying on suit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely going down a decent road of Disney. Stuff for the moment.
The live action stuff I quite dubious when they announced it. Just leave them the classics. Leave them me.
Yeah.
But then I was like, we showed it earlier. Peach Dragon's going to be about 40 years old, if not older.
Yeah, I remember it on VHS when I were a kid, and it's before me, so that's 28 years.
I'm 34, and I remember it having on VHS, and that went long after it came out. Yeah. So.
I mean, it was same sort of style as Bedknobs and Broomsticks and Mary Poppins, wasn't it?
It's got to be 50-odd years old.
Yeah, 40-50, I'd say.
Right, so we're the last generation to remember it.
Yeah.
Everyone else is kind of like, kids that have seen it now have probably never seen Peach Dragon.
Yeah. I mean, mine have, because we watched it on Sky not long back during holidays.
Yeah, but the audience, there's not going to be that many that have seen it. This is their generation's Peach Dragon, which is fine. I don't mind that, because they're doing it. That trailer looks amazing. I've got proper chills and goosebumps from it.
And you can put it in this theory, we're rebooting loads of stuff. It's not as if it's got the time frame of how many times we've rebooted Spider-Man. There's a massive time frame to when they reboot in this film.
Yeah, it's not 2 years later, but this is 40, 50 years later. Yeah. We'll reboot, and it's not cashing on the name. They've changed the story. Certain aspects of the story. Yeah. They've changed the design. It's not a cartoon dragon. It's a CGI one. It's live action. I think it's. Yeah, it's brilliant. I'm all for it.
I think as you pointed out as well, they haven't got bumblebee wings anymore.
Yeah.
Wings that can actually carry his body weight.
I mean, am I the only one that I'm watching that? I felt like a little kid in the trailer. He runs and jumps off a cliff.
Yeah.
And then it all goes silent.
Yeah.
And it's just a set, and then he comes up on dragon, and you're like, yes. Yeah. A little kid inside, yes, go on. He's like, I love Disney. That's pure Disney magic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to it.
I was glad they showed him disappearing as well.
Just go invisible at one point. Yeah.
When I saw the trailer, I thought, he's got to be the imaginary. And then he disappeared. I thought, oh, thank God for that.
I hope they have that scene where he's walking through town and you just see the footprints.
Yeah.
And they don't necessarily need to have all the singing and stuff. They had it not to be a musical, but just have that little scene where you just see the footprints.
Because they had the medicine man, didn't they? Was it the medicine man?
Yeah, it was the medicine man in the original one who was trying to hunt him because he can make medicine out of him.
So I'm wondering whether they'll have something in there.
Yeah, it's Judge Dredd this time, Carl Urban, Dr. McCoy.
Yeah.
So maybe he's wanting to make medical stuff out of him. Kirk sent him back to get him.
Dragon tears.
We'll let you announce the next story, seeing as we've got Spider-Man here.
Well, what's next? So we've got Homecoming coming up. I know there was a bit on the possible other Spider-Man coming into it, Donald Glover.
Yeah, and Donald Glover, he's been cast in Homecoming, that's confirmed.
Yeah.
He was rumoured before to be playing Miles Morales it got taken back to Marvel.
Yeah.
He has voiced Miles Morales.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
In the animated series. In Ultimate Spider-Man, I think he's voiced him.
Is it Ultimate Spider-Man?
I think it's Ultimate Spider-Man. Right. He's voiced Miles Morales. but it's not been confirmed that he's Miles Morales.
No.
He's a lot older than Tom Holland.
Yeah.
Which would be a swap around from the comics, which we've discussed this before.
Yeah, I don't mind at all. I know that there'll be a lot of hate on it, and to be honest, do Marvel really care? Marvel are doing a bloody good job, and they have gone against quite a decent amount of comic origins, but they're still doing it justice.
Yeah.
So they've proved that it doesn't matter if they don't follow it to the T, they still do a bloody good job.
Yeah, and it's like Civil War has really nothing to do with the comics.
No. Yeah.
There's no in there that's really, apart from two sides fighting each other, there's no really in there.
Do you reckon we'd have this same reaction if it was just Sony doing it on their own?
No.
Without Marvel's interference?
No, because this, the reason we're having this reaction and going, it's fine, let them do what they want, or we'll be happy with it, is the same argument that I have against DC Universe, is that Marvel have spent over a decade doing this now.
Yeah.
We've got 13 films, is it, I think?
Yeah.
They've taken the time, they've planted the seeds, they've grown. Like, if you look at Civil War, that's such a complex movie when you look at it like 2-3 viewings. It's not only is it a great ensemble movie, it's essentially an Avengers team up.
Yeah.
It's the accumulation of a trilogy. Every part of Civil War is kind of interwoven through Winter Soldier and leads back to First Avenger.
Yeah.
It's very well written, so it's
kind of booking cap story, isn't it?
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah. So it's that kind of when we're going to the change in the origin story, or you know, Miles Bradis is older and all this stuff, and we're going, that's fine, we're okay with that.
Yeah.
Because we've got so much trust. Yeah. Like you said, they haven't put a foot wrong yet.
Yeah.
No. The only bad film, the weakest film they've had, in my opinion anyway, is Thor Dark World, which is a pretty good film.
And I class Iron Man 3 as one of the weaker ones as well. You don't agree with me.
I quite like Iron Man 3. I'm one of the minority that like the Mandarin twist because it kind of keeps him for later.
Yeah.
And it was
quite comical. Well, this is the thing, they've stored him, haven't they?
Well, there's
still
a little,
got the option of Mandarin the one to
shot.
Come back.
There's the one shot on the DVD, on the extras, there's the one shot that shows there's a real Mandarin out there.
Yeah.
Which I think could work quite well in it. It was a massive surprise when they did what they did, but I didn't mind it.
I thought it were quite funny. I love Ben Kingsley as an actor anyway. That seemed amazing. It was just something to, it goes from Mandarin to Trevor. That was brilliant. I think an older Miles Morales is fine. I mean, the theory that we were reading earlier was that one of the theories we read was that he's going to be, or they want him to be, more wishful thinking, was that he'd be a teacher. Peter's school.
Or maybe a lab assistant at Oscorp.
Yeah, and he gets his powers later.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's older, he's just got his powers, and it's kind of Peter, even though he's younger, he's still his mentor because he's teaching him how to control them and stuff.
Yeah.
I like the idea of it. I don't know if I like the idea of it being in school or not. I like being a teacher's school because in the idea that Michael Keaton is a teacher at his school.
There's rumours of that as well.
And becomes a vulture. So is it just going to be, some kind of high school meta tank or something?
Possibly, yeah.
Is it just Oscorp just testing on students and everybody comes out of the high school? It's just, I think I get a bit bored of that.
Yeah. I mean, you complain Gotham about that Hugo Strange is practically making everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think it should be. Have Michael Keaton be the Vulture and Miles Morales is a lab assistant at Oscorp, or the other way around or something. Yeah. But I think both of them is too much.
Mm. I mean, what's quite good is they've not really got how he's become Spider-Man anyway, have they? So you've got it quite open.
It's a long story.
It's basically, I think they're just ignoring it.
Yeah.
It's just a case of like, well, yeah, give him an origin story. Everyone knows the origin story. Yeah. You don't need to see him called Ben Dead again. You all know it.
I can't do it again.
You've all seen it. You all know it. Move along. Why waste 40 minutes of a film setting it up? Been set up a good, how many times in 4 years, five years?
Yeah, I mean, it could work anyway. I mean, Uncle Ben's Rise is a black guy. It could be the actual Spider-Man. We won't go there.
Carrying on Marvel theories, quickly move along from the racism.
Yeah.
Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Yeah. Mm. We've read an interesting one this morning.
Yeah.
We don't usually report fan theories.
Yeah. I mean, We talked on like Miles Morales there, what it could be, kind of a fan theory, but that's because Donald Glover's confirmed as casting.
Yeah.
This is a big fan theory, but we like it because it's a tiny bit of, we've got Kurt Russell and Ahmed Sylvester Stallone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Who we go to the cinema with every now and again. They're both casting guys at Galaxy 2.
Yes.
Now Sharon Stone, that's confirmed.
Yeah.
Sharon Stone has been confirmed from Marvel Project and has heat powers.
Yeah.
That's all we know.
Well, what she said on The Late Show with James Corden is, I've got a wee bit in a Marvel project.
Yeah.
So, and that's it, and then...
And she's confirmed later on she has heat powers.
Yeah.
That's all we know,
right. Sharon Stone.
Now, the thing is, we've got two time gems missing still. Two Phoenix Stone's missing.
Yeah.
One of them's a time gem.
Yeah.
Is Guardians of the Galaxy 2 going to feature the time gem? Sharon Stone, Kurt Russell and Sylvester Stallone going to be the original Guardians from the 1969 comic book run?
Yeah.
Meeting up with the Guardians of the Galaxy we know now, Star-Lord, Raccoon, Groot and all that lot.
Yeah.
Meet up via the time gem.
Possibly. I mean, we know the villain of it is going to be Aisha.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who is Star Fox's dad, and that's who Kurt Russell's rumoured to be playing.
No, she, Aisha's...
Sorry, it's Star Fox's mother. Yeah.
Kurt Russell's rumoured to be playing Star Fox, who is going to be Star-Lord's dad.
Well, we know he's playing Star-Lord's dad, we just don't know which character he is.
Yeah, so
he's
not, rumoured
he's not the dad from the comics.
Yeah, he's rumoured he's going to be Star Fox.
Yeah.
Who was an original member of the Guardians of the Galaxy. So kind of, this theory fits...
Yeah.
It fits nice, and there's no real holes in it.
Yeah.
You know, they get the time gem, it puts them in a different frame of time, where you've got the original Guardians, and that's how he meets his dad, and...
Yeah.
I think it ties it all up nicely. I think that... that but, well, I mean, James Gunn isn't helping.
No.
With his What We Shot Wednesday tweets.
Yeah. I mean, Sharon Stone said that, then. He released a concept art of someone with the head on fire.
Yeah, which would, I can't remember the last season, time put it down, but it would be the character, one of the characters of the original Guardians of the Galaxy that Sharon Stone could be playing.
Yeah.
And it's like, you're not helping him, right? When it did a week, he put the, just put up a picture, he tweeted a picture of him holding Mjolnir on the set. And it's like, what the hell have you got Mjolnir on Guardians of the Galaxy 2?
Yeah, it's actually gone on record the next day. Look, Thor's not in the movie, it was just a prop that I managed to get hold of, and I don't believe it.
You wouldn't.
It reminds me of the J.J. Abrams tweet when everyone was going on about the Falcon being in Star Wars.
Yeah.
And he tweeted a picture of a little note, saying just a piece of paper saying the Millennium Falcon is not in Star Wars. Categorically, is not in Star Wars Episode 7. Can you please stop these rumours?
Yeah.
And that note was sort of like askew when he took the picture of it. And just underneath it, in the corner there, you could see a round chessboard with a blue outline. And it's like, everyone just went, fucking, it's not, it's categorically not in the Millennium Falcon. Why the fuck have you got the chest bomb from there? So I don't believe James Gunn. Yeah. And by theory, we've gone through my theory before on the show, I think, where it's Hulk's going to be Ragnarok, Thor and Hulk will go chasing Loki through space, and then they'll meet up with the Guardians, and that'll pass it to Guardians of Galaxy 2, and that's how they come to Earth.
Right.
But speaking of James Gunn being a troll online... he's also been at it with San Diego.
Yeah.
San Diego Comic Con's coming out, and the director for
Doctor Strange,
I can't remember the guy's name now.
I can't now.
He tweeted, because quite famously, Marvel wasn't at San Diego Comic Con last year, the D23 Expo instead. The director from Doctor Strange has tweeted, am I going to be at San Diego Comic Con this year?
Yeah.
And there's a picture of a lamppost with San Diego Comic Con, and then Doctor Strange on the other side of it.
Yeah.
You're not really good at cryptic, fella.
And then what would James Gunn's tweet afterwards? Oh, I can't believe how close you are. I'll have to come and say hello.
Oh, you'll be so close by. I'll have to pop by and say hello.
Yeah.
That's how you do cryptic.
Yeah.
You just kind of go, Doctor Strange at San Diego Comic Con. Does that mean, is Guardians filming nearby? Is James Gunn going to be near? Is Guardians Galaxy 2 going to get some footage at San Diego? Didn't they just set on fucking fire?
Yeah.
And these two are just trolling for fun. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Yeah.
I think it's amazing. So, there was a little bit on the end of this, which I really liked, was Kevin Feige got asked why they wanted San Diego this year.
Yeah.
Last year. And he turned around and said, we'd just done the media event where they released all of Phase 3, what's coming out. So they said we knew what we were doing for years. And me personally, if you haven't got anything to, if you're going to go to San Diego Comic Con, you have to over deliver.
Yeah.
If you can't over deliver, don't go.
Yeah.
I love that. Everyone went mental. There's no Marvel. It's kind of going to go big or go home.
Yeah.
We went home. Yeah. I love it. So hopefully, we're going to get some. I want to see the proper. I think it's about time for the proper theatrical trailer release of Doctor Strange.
Yes.
At San Diego Comic Con, I think that'd be the right time.
Yeah.
Time-wise to release the first trailer.
So looking forward to it.
Yeah, I really am. And I think maybe some teaser footage from Guardians 2.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, the wrap filming next week and it goes into post-production.
We've got a couple of months.
Yeah.
About a month.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think we'll see something from Guardians. Not a full-length trailer.
No.
Just a teaser.
Just a bit of teaser footage. You know, kind of like PC, like Warner Brothers did with the Joker.
Yeah.
A few year back.
Yeah.
Then you get something like that. Yeah. Or maybe just, tell you what, we don't even need footage from it.
No.
And exactly how to melt all H. Man, you're getting all H. Bring the Guardian of the Galaxy logo up.
Yeah.
Play a song.
Yeah.
And then hand out free CDs of Awesome Mix Volume 2.
Yes. Yeah.
That's it. Done. We're not footage. We haven't got any cast here.
Yeah.
We haven't got any actors. Here, have a free CD. Awesome Mix Volume 2 and watch the internet just fucking explode.
Yeah.
There's no footage or anything, you just give the soundtrack. Just give the soundtrack listed out.
Oh, that's brilliant.
And everyone'll just go fucking awesome. Nuts. Yeah. That's exact Marvel, that's what you need. Get in touch. We say this every week, we've got the ideas why we sat here.
Yeah.
Speaking of how to do things properly.
Yeah, this has been a brilliant story, this friend of the show, Kevin Smith.
Yeah.
Because we know he's a friend of the show because he steals a lot of our things for Fat Man on Batman.
He has done quite a lot.
Yeah.
Don't give us credit, but he does it a lot.
Yeah. But,
it's a good job we love you, Kev.
Yeah. Mulligan's 2, been rumoured for a sequel for quite a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Big story behind it is, I'll let you tell the full story, but it's going to a 10-part TV series.
Yeah, I've got here. My in-depth reporting, as you've come to expect from Stoffel Presents, is Mallrats 2 is a 10-part series, fuck you, Universal.
Yeah.
Which is basically what Kevin Smith, first of all, round of applause for this. This is fucking...
genius.
Basically, he went on a radio show last week and just dropped the entire story. But he wanted to do Mallrats 2.
Yeah.
So he asked his agent, look, if I write the script, can we get the title off of Universal, because they own it. And his agent went, yeah, not a problem, no worries.
Yeah.
So he says, basically, you can do it, finance it yourself, fully finance yourself, have it fully financed by the studio, or co-finance it.
Yeah.
And I think the best way you're getting this Mallrats 2 made is to fully finance it yourself.
Yeah.
So Kevin Smith went away, wrote the script, went back to his agent, right, I've finished, do we have to submit it to Universal? And basically, his agent turned and said, yeah, so we submit it, We thought they're going to say no.
Yeah.
But we submit it so that they can pass up on it, and when they say no, we don't want it, then we can go, right, well, we'll buy the title.
Yeah.
We'll buy the rights to it. Universal said no to it. They went to buy the title, and Universal, this is quite a cool little fact, Universal has never, ever, ever sold any of its catalogue.
No.
I didn't know this much, but it's never sold any of its rights or given them away.
Yeah.
So they refused to do it. So Mallrats 2 became Mallbrats.
Yeah.
But it can't be released as a film because it's Mallrats 2. Mallrats and Mallbrats, it's kind of a spiritual successor to it. It's kind of gets shorter and then get the fun after it. It won't get shorter, but it was a sequel, won't it? Get something else. Kevin Smith decided, fuck you, Universal, then. Mallrats is now a 10-part TV series and they can do fuck all about the licensing.
Yeah.
It's going to see the return of 18 characters.
Yep, and 4 new ones.
6 new ones.
6 new ones.
I'm really looking forward to this. And it's going to be filmed in the Exxon Mall.
Yeah.
Which is in Philadelphia, which is where Mallrats was filmed.
Yeah,
so they have to be. This is Mallrats 2.
Yeah.
Everything except name, and it's a 10-part series instead of a movie.
Yeah.
Do you know, we hit 10 hours of Mallrats instead of 2.5. Yeah. I'm well, I'll take that. So yeah, well played, Kevin. That is beautiful and, you know, Universal. Well done for starting by your guns. But, you know, you've never sold a catalogue and you're not going to start out. That's fair enough, I get that. That's honourable, I suppose. But it's kind of shitty as well.
Yeah.
Like, you've been given you own the rights to it, you've been given the script, you don't want it, you don't think it's going to go anywhere, that's fine, okay then. But we're going to keep the title. So, I mean, you don't want to do it with the title, no, we're just going to keep it in this drawer here so no one can use it. That's a bit shitty.
Yeah.
How many great projects have Universal got involved that they have no intention of using, but won't sell it because it's like, that's mine, you can't have it.
I mean, was it Universal that bought New Line and they're the reason that we can't have Freddy vs. Jason vs. Ash or Freddy vs. Jason 2?
Yeah.
It's also.
They've no intention of doing anything with it, but they don't want to sell the rights to it.
Yeah.
It's basically hoarders.
Yeah.
You know that weird dude that lives at Endy Street and his house stinks when you walk past and he's got 44 years worth of newspapers in his living room and he hasn't seen his sofa for 20 years. It's Universal.
Yeah. Just scripts.
grips in a vault.
Yeah.
It's a bit like your corporation's buying land, isn't it? And it's like, no one is going to do anything here. We're not going to do all with it, but no one else
can do it.
Yeah, it's
originally it's like seen from end of Raiders of Lost Ark. So we're doing more rocks too. No, here's a script, go take it now. He just keeps running out and it's bigger and bigger.
Do you not think there should be some kind of law on it?
Well,
because I know, like,
there is with certain things, so if you don't make anything within 10 years.
No, but that's not a law, that's in the contract.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Fantastic Four, if they had 18 months with which to release a film,
yeah.
Otherwise it reverted back to Marvel, yeah. That's because it's in the contract.
Yeah.
These are contracts, is what Universal outright owned them.
Yeah.
You know, I think there should be some kind of law that it's kind of like, well, if you're not going to use that title for 25 years. So, I know, like, with books. A book, if it's you release a book after 25 years, it becomes in the public domain.
Yeah.
And your copyright's lifted. Some on music as well, there's a certain length of copyright on music. Although I think that got lifted and it's now indefinite. But yeah, I think there should be something where that stops people from doing this. How many great titles are there that have got sequels in it?
Yeah.
It should be a case, and I'm not saying, right, after 25 years, anyone can go do what the fuck they want with it.
Yeah.
This is why we've got two Jungle Books.
Yeah.
We've got the Disney live action one, and there's another one coming out.
Yeah, I think Sony were doing one as well.
Yeah, it's coming out February, March time, I think it is. But
that's they're all both due to come out at the same time.
But that's simply because that book is so many years old. I think it's like 5 years old, which means it's in the public domain, no one has the copyright to it. So I think it should be a case like, right, if you're not going to do it with this property after 25 years or 30 years, you're not going to do it with that title, it goes to auction.
Yeah.
Not saying anyone can use it for free, but either you have to do something with it. You can't just renew it and put it in vault again.
Yeah.
But it has to go to auction and you can't buy it.
Yeah.
So then Universal will have to sell more rats in 5 years' time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And people can offer it. But then I suppose you're just going to get people buying it and vaulting it again. But
yeah, maybe.
I don't know. I'm not an expert. I just think it should be like this. Yeah. How many?
Just wherever this auction is, tell Fox it's somewhere else.
Yeah. could we have something amazing like Flight of the Navigator 2?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it's never going to get made because it's in Universal's vault.
Possibly.
You know, I don't know. Yeah. Anyway, speaking of, well, the titles that are getting made again.
Yeah, Beverly Hills Cop 4.
You can take this, I'm staying quiet on this one. No. Go on.
Yeah, Eddie Murphy is coming back as Axel Foley in Beverly Hills Cop 4, but Brett Ratner is not directing anymore. He's passed up on it, and we're getting these two Belgian guys called
Belgish?
Yeah, Belgish.
Two Belgish guys.
Yeah, Belgian. Called El Arbi and Fala. They're taking the project forward. I don't know much about them. Apparently, they've done an acclaimed drama called Black. Can't speak.
Belgish guys who did Brack.
and that was big at last year's Toronto Film Festival, and that's all I really know about that story.
There's certain times where the director is as important as the actor.
Yeah.
Star Wars had multiple directors. There's a different director for every film, I think.
Yeah.
That's fine, it works.
Yeah.
But stuff like Beverly Hills Cop has to be that director.
Yeah.
It's his vision. He brought it to life.
Yeah.
There's certain franchises where it... Like now, Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
Can't be anything but James Gunn.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, I can't see him bringing it. If they were, oh, so-and-so's directing now, I'm fucking not. just like, certain directors should be permanently attached. It was, I forgot the guy's name who did Ghostbusters. He was brought back to.
Ivan Reitman.
Yeah, Reitman, that's it.
Yeah.
He was brought back originally to do Ghostbusters 3, which then he got forced out by the head of Fox, and now we've got the abomination it is.
Yeah.
But he should be, anything Ghostbusters, it's him.
Yeah.
I forgot the guy's name mentioned again now for. Beverly Hills Cop.
Brett Ratner.
Brett Ratner, that's it.
Yeah.
Beverly Hills Cop gets mentioned, it should be him.
Yeah.
You know, you mentioned Ratner, Beverly Hills Cop, you mentioned Reitman, Ghostbusters, you mentioned Snyder, nothing at all, ever again. but do we need this?
No. I think this is just Eddie Murphy cashing in.
He's
been out of limelight for so long, but he's probably paying too much maintenance to Scary Spice and...
Yeah. I think it's one of those that I love Beverly Hills Cop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely love it. I think we watched him about 6 or 7 months ago. I showed my son him for the first time.
Yeah.
We did the whole trilogy in a weekend and absolutely loved them. So maybe it's good for him, but is Eddie Murphy a bit old to play it now?
Yeah.
Is it relevant?
Are we getting Doug Rhino back as well?
I mean, is he relevant?
I don't think he is.
He's
a talking donkey of this generation. That's
it. Yeah. He's not. His acting isn't really up to par to today's standards. I mean, I love Beverly Hills Cop, but the level of acting now is so much higher than what it was.
Yeah.
In the early 90s, I don't think it's.
Yeah, I forgot what the last one he did, that Tower Heist or whatever it was.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that was terrible.
Well, this is why it's more successful being animated now, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's an animated voice, isn't it?
I think it's one of them where it's kind of Adam Sandler kind of range of people now, where Adam Sandler was funny 10 years ago, but comedy's evolved now and is just a pale imitation of what we want. He hasn't moved with the times, I think.
No, Adam Sandler just phones it in. Yeah. But you deal with Netflix, and I can just put it out here.
Yeah, but back in the day, Adam Sandler was hilarious.
Yeah. But you watch Waterboy and Big Daddy now, they're still piss funny and Happy Gilmore.
Yeah, they're still piss funny, it's just he hasn't moved.
Like Ben Stiller.
Yeah. You know, Ben Stiller's same, Ben Stiller.
I've not even bothered watching Zoolander 2, because I don't think he's even changed.
It's worth it for Bieber dying.
Yeah, I've seen the advert. You know, he dies on the advert. I've seen it.
Yeah, you've seen it. Yeah,
I didn't know he died in the advert.
Yeah, it shows you in the advert in trailer.
All right.
It's one of the biggest draws to the cinema, isn't it? You see Bieber die. Right, we're off.
Well, I've already seen it, and I can repeat it as much as I can on adverts. So,
you don't
need to do it. No, time freeze it.
Speaking of directors, anyway. The other gift that keeps on giving...
Channing Tatum. Is he playing Gambit?
Not the moment. Doug Lindman, who was signed on to direct when Gambit goes to shoot, he's now directing Chaos Walking at the exact same time, so we don't know if they've lost a director or it's just another delay.
Yeah, Doug Lindman signed up to do direct Gambit.
Yeah.
And it's come out in the last couple of days that he's also signed to do Chaos Walking, the both film at the same time.
Yeah.
So either one of them's getting put back.
Yeah.
Or he's walking from one of them.
I don't think it's Chaos Walking with it being announced this week.
Yeah. The fact that he was announced to do Gambit before.
Yeah.
And he's just kind of gone, this film is never coming out. I'll fucking sign this, mate. Don't this clash be the same time you're filming Gambit? Yeah. No one's filming Gambit.
I think Channing Tatum's son's going to be playing Gambit or Channing Tatum.
But his great grandson. Is this just the gift to get? I mean, the thing is, we take the piss out of this every week.
Yeah.
But I love Gambit, he's my favourite X-Man.
Yeah. I was so looking forward to it when I heard about it. I thought, brilliant, Gambit. Yeah. Where is it?
Just goes further and further into the horizon.
It's supposed to be out in a couple of months.
It's supposed to be nearly out and not even started filming yet.
It was supposed to be coming off of the back of X-Men Apocalypse.
And Hugh Jackman will be on Wolverine 20 by the time he's actually got a release date.
Well, this is the thing, right? You've got to have the fucked it already in my book, because one of the major things about Gambit is his interaction with Wolverine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
In Hugh Jackman, we're going to go on to it's next story, but Hugh Jackman is in Wolverine 3.
Yeah.
And he's hanging up the claws.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Gambit's fucked up, but if it was coming out in a couple of months, they could have had a cameo or something, the scene with Hugh Jackman.
Yeah.
Now, by the time it comes out, he's going to, we need you to play Wolverine for a couple of scenes. I stopped doing that 4 years ago, mate. Just no.
But will they bring in the new Wolverine?
Yeah.
I don't...
You said it should never be recast, didn't
you? I said it should never be recast.
I'm so. I think they could do it, but if they recast it, he's got to have his original suit. Because that'll win me over a little bit.
I think it's one of them where you can't recast Wolverine, you can't recast Iron Man, you can't recast Captain America. The idea of the other, I think, continue the storyline, but instead of having Wolverine, you replace him with X-23.
Yeah.
They have X-23 instead of Wolverine in there.
The thing that's going to annoy me, though, I mean, with Hugh Jackman hanging up the claws, at the end of X-Men Apocalypse, they all got the fucking 90s suits.
Yep.
And no Wolverine in the 90s film, which is the next X-Men film.
It is. Yeah. Horrible.
They've got a recast one, I think.
I don't.
Just for the yellow and blue suit, I don't care.
You don't recast him.
Yeah, CGI him.
Just CGI him. You just have some dude. Don't even have Wolverine in it. The next film's a 90s one. Doesn't have Wolverine in it. They don't even mention him. They don't make reference to him. I don't like that. And then when the girl suit, there was a scene where the girl suit up to get in Blackbird.
Yeah.
And they get the suits out and there's just his suit hanging there. You don't mention it, you don't pay attention to it, you just have it hanging there in the corners and at least when you walk off.
Yeah. Oh,
the Deadpool notice it. Deadpool notices it. Morgan! Just carries on. Oh, nice, you're giving me suit when he's gone. Oh, yeah. That's nice of you.
Yeah.
Oh, could have watched McCallick cameo. Oh, God, what's he called? He's in all Marvels. He is Marvel.
Stan Lee.
That's the one. Stan Lee Marvel.
Is Stan Lee in a Wolverine suit? In a blue suit.
I'm retired now, delivering pizza.
This is a dark one that I know nothing about next.
Yep.
San Andreas. It's the director of San Andreas. I'm going to let you talk this one out.
Yep. There's another comic book adaptation coming from a company called Boom Comics. Not really heard of them. I've not even heard of the title man until this morning. I did a bit of research on it. But the San Andreas director is directing The Malignant Man.
That's a cool superhero name. Very cheery.
Yeah.
is that shot for Malignant Melanoma Man?
Pretty much, yeah. He's a cancer sufferer.
Yeah, there it is then.
Yeah, who gets cured by parasitic aliens and they give him mutant powers and he goes off and fights crime.
Different.
Yeah. I'm going down to OK Comics to pick up a few comic books now, I think.
Yeah.
I might get the Malignant Man on back order, I think.
Yeah.
Well, that sounds interesting.
It does, yeah. Well, I'll show you out more about it. It's like one of these really low-budget indie comics.
Is it a case of the parasites leaving and he loses his powers, or does he now, the parasites leaving, does the cancer come back, does it cure him, or does he just hold it at bay?
What I've read out is, well, it's as much as I know.
Yeah. When I looked at that, like The Malignant Man, I was like, oh, that's a very cheery title. Yeah. But the more I think about it, there's so much scope for depth in this that I'll definitely be picking that up.
Especially with a comic character not many people know much about, you can pretty much take it in your own direction. I mean, you're going to offend, 50 people?
Remember the last time we got an original new character?
Yeah.
You know, we get Superman rebooted, or we get the X-Men rebooted. Yeah.
I've thought about anything like this since Watchmen.
Yeah.
Because I didn't really know much about Watchmen, because that was a standalone title.
Yeah, so I like when we finally get a really original new character.
Yeah.
But it has depth to him. It's not a Superman ripoff or a Spawn. Yeah. You normally get like a Spawn ripoff or Ghost Rider type thing, but this sounds interesting.
It's a good time for it to be coming as well, isn't it?
Yeah,
what's going on?
Right in the middle of the boom.
Yeah. Right in the middle of comic book movies, and then and that's it. This is not a film. It's a little known comic publishers.
Yeah,
but I've never heard of them, and I've never heard of this title.
Yeah,
but if this is getting a movie, that's going to be a big fucking pull for them because people watch this and right in the middle of comic book movie boom, and like, fuck, that's different. I'm down my comic book store. What else do Boom Comics do?
My only worry is the first two words of my notes, which is San Andreas, which was just a terrible, terrible, terrible film.
Yeah, but it's the director, not the scriptwriter.
Yeah.
So, we'll see.
I
don't get this, but people like blame the director for San Andreas, and you think, you didn't write it. It's the writing that's the problem with that.
Yeah.
And it's like, yeah, but he directed it. Yeah. If someone paid me if someone offered me 20 million quid to do Spice Girls the movie, I'd do it. You know what I mean? It's just like, I'll do that. Like, that is a shocking film. Yeah, you see my bank account there. Say the end of joy you want. I'm going to go driving my limo to my hot tub with Playboy Bunnies in it.
The thing is, you can only direct with what you've been given.
Yeah.
You know, and if you're doing a good job so with it.
Yeah. While we're on the thing of directors, Battlestar Galactica movie has it been confirmed now? Because it was rumoured there's going to be one.
The movie's definitely going ahead. It's being given a writer, chief writer, which is Lisa Joy.
Lisa Joy's the main writer, sorry, yeah.
Yeah, and the director is the Hunger Games director, Ajax Lawrence.
Yeah, we're having that joke now because it's Francis Lawrence, but I wrote it Francis is in Deadpool, and that's what his name was.
Yeah.
So it's Jack Lawrence.
Yeah.
But yeah, so it was kind of rumoured it was going to happen, and then it has a writer and a director now, so that's going ahead. I don't know. Do we know if it's tied to the TV series? Is it?
I have no idea.
Is it a continuation of the new TV series, or does it ignore completely and continue from the original series, or is it just complete reboot starting again?
Probably
it'll
be a reboot,
I would
imagine.
It will be,
won't it? Probably so. Does that mean we're going to get a third type of Cylon?
Probably, yeah. It'll probably be some big CGI mess.
We had the original Cylons that looked cool, and then you had the new ones in the... I fell out with the series for a really stupid reason. I've never watched past the first episode.
Right.
I'll go into it now, actually. But yeah, the Cylons in that were completely different, weren't they? And
yeah.
Quite sleek and money. But yeah, I watched the first episode because Showbiz went on about this amazing series.
Yeah.
And about halfway through, a third of the way through, they find out the bridge has been tapped or hacked or something because this box is right there in the centre.
Yeah.
At the main console of the bridge. You've got the captain, who is number one, and the technical officer all around this three panel control system. There's a big box in front of their eyes. Right? And that's been hacking them.
Yeah.
And no one noticed it. And when they bring it up, it's like, well, but I thought you knew, but I thought you authorised it on the last refit.
Yeah.
I thought you authorised it. I just assumed you did. You're like, I mean, you three are in charge of the ship. There's a big fucking box that you've never seen before. Sure. And not one of you go, what's this do? You know, I'm done. I'm out. I don't care how cool your show is, how awesome it is.
I thought we went on to a silent point then where he started sort of story.
No, it's just like they've got a box out, no one notices it, or like, decides to ask, oh, did you put this in? No, thought you put it in, no? Get the fucker out then, what's it doing? No, just carry on, it's alright, don't mention it. I was just like, yeah, I'm done, don't do stupid in it. But yeah, we're going to have a third Cylon?
More than likely, yeah.
Might be another box.
Yeah.
We're going to have a box on bridge that no one asks about.
We have Dirk Benedict in it, though.
Yeah, we'll have Dirk Benedict in it, please. But yeah, we're going to have another Cylon. We're going to get a third Cylon.
Yeah.
Because of merchandise.
Yes.
Merchandise makes the books.
Yeah. We'll take the gate to C-3PO's red arm.
Yeah.
Let's not start you on that again.
No. I'm going to read this out and let you defend it since it's what you do every week. My in-depth notes here is Gotham. He's challenging Legends of Tomorrow for the most fucked up understanding of time.
I can't really defend this decision.
I don't think anyone can.
They recast Poison Ivy and added 5 years to her because they've cast someone in the late teens. She's no longer a 13-year-old girl. See, everyone stays the same age.
We've mentioned this time discrepancy in Gotham before where Jim Gordon has his trial and gets sent to prison in the same time it takes Bruce Wayne to drink a cup of tea.
Yeah.
There's not a due process or anything.
Yeah.
He's been in a couple of months, but his missus is suddenly... Like, Bruce's story doesn't develop, but his missus is suddenly 6 months heavily pregnant.
And lost baby.
And lost baby, which you want before.
Yeah.
You know, so, but even now, apparently, everyone's age... Like, now, let's say everyone's age...
I think the only way you can get around this is if you recast Bruce and Selina.
Yeah.
But you can't because they're too big on the show.
So is it the only way for me to get around it is to have some kind of plant-based science accident that ages her?
Yeah.
But then that's tenuous.
Yeah.
But yeah, so it's, let's say episode one of next season is 2 months after the end of last one.
Yeah.
End of season finale on this one. That means everyone's 2 months older, except Poison Ivy, who's 5 years older.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless we have like one of the monsters that have escaped, he's like a succubus, you know, that sucks the life out of you, and they've just got all the Poison Ivy at end before Jim rescues her, and it's like aged her 5 years.
I think the only way is like...
We're might grasping at straws, I don't know how you're doing over there.
Yeah, we normally fight like this, seem far. It's so early we fire ideas out like that, let's be cool, let's do it this way. This one we're just like, yeah, you're only fucking on.
It's got to be a plant accident.
It's going to be a plant accident or something.
You know, I mean, Kat is with her best friend who's younger than her and all of a sudden she's got breasts.
Yeah. What kind of plant accident has that been? This plant accident is going to... She ages quicker. So does that mean, like, in 2 years' time she's going to be 10 years older than Kat? If she ages quicker? Or is it just, for some magical, undescribed reason, aged her 5 years and stops?
Yeah, she could go into like a cocoony thing and blossom. I don't know, it's gonna be shit.
In-depth commentating, it's gonna be, I don't know, it's gonna be shit.
I don't know, I'm trying to battle for it, but it's just not working.
I mean, I spent most of like the second half of season two of Gotham on Excelsior just slating it.
Yeah.
It gets worse and worse every week.
There were times I couldn't defend it, like the Gordon trial, that were inexcusable.
Or Jim just ordering police officers around and nicking whatever he wants. The fact I hate is the fact that Jim Gordon has been sent to prison for murder, he's been cleared, but he's not been allowed to join the police force again.
Yeah.
He commits crime, like, on an hourly basis.
Yeah.
He steals shit or goes vigilante and stuff. This guy's supposed to be whiter than white becoming Commissioner Gordon.
Yeah.
The one that really broke it for me was he broke out of prison. And I went, but that's all right, breaking out's all right because you didn't do that crime in the first place. No, breaking out's still illegal.
Yeah, yeah. Whether you've been cleared of that crime or not, you still committed the crime of breaking out of prison. Yeah. They don't just go, sorry, it's all right, off you go. They go, fair enough, you are exonerated of that charge. There's nothing on your record about that at all ever again. Yeah. You cleared a bit. We apologise for that.
Not to mention a convicted criminal you also helped. Yeah. Escape and
now, yeah. Now, this charge of you breaking out of prison, assisting a convicted felon escaping prison, you're going back to prison, mate. But no, they just go, yeah, move along, it's fine.
Yeah.
It's fucking ridiculous writing.
Yeah. But while we're on Gotham anyway, the new addition to the cast, Vicky Vale, who you may remember as the reporter that Kim Basinger plays.
Yeah, I mean, Vicky Vale is brilliant in the Batman animated series.
Yeah.
She's popped up a couple of times then, she's been brilliant. She's a really good character.
Yeah.
One of my favourite characters in Gotham. She's one of those. So in the Arkham games as well, she drives the plot quite a bit in Arkham Asylum.
Yeah.
She's
investigative journalist.
She's a thinking man's Lois Lane.
Yeah.
Like Lois Lane is just basically, she pretends to be a journalist but ends up just screaming for Superman to come help her.
Yeah.
Vicky Vale doesn't give a fuck. She goes into everything. She's a proper investigative journalist. She'll investigate the Joker and all the mafia bosses and stuff like that. I think there's a few times when Batman saves and she tells him off for it.
Yeah.
Maybe she can explain to us how Poison Ivy aged.
Yeah. She's going to do a good expose, like a big investigative journalism piece on it and find out why. And then the last bit, which I think is a bit of non-news, but Matt Lucas is returning to Doctor Who.
Yeah. It was Missy's assistant wanting the Christmas episode.
No, Rivers' assistant.
Rivers' assistant, yeah. Rivers, yeah, not Missy's.
I don't know why this is big news. It was a big news. Matt Lucas returned to Doctor Who. It took us 20 minutes to remember who it was.
Yeah.
And it was in Doctor Who. When? What did he play? Yeah. No, it was the Christmas episode.
Yeah.
With Greg Davis.
Yeah.
In the big, with just his head in the big robot suit. He was in it for about 2 minutes?
I think it was longer than that.
Well, he kind of comes up and says, yeah, it was...
Popping in and out.
Yeah, he's returning Doctor Who. Yeah. That's the story.
Yeah, and that's it for this week.
Yeah, that's it for this week. We're quite a long show, I think.
Yeah.
But yeah, as usual, get in touch with us at stockwellpresents.wix.com/home.
Yep, there you'll find all the social media buttons, Patreon, YouTube, Facebook.
Yeah, subscribe and like on YouTube. Hop up to the website, click on Patreon, give us a bit of cash, help us out.
Yeah.
And until next time, take care, Geek Fals.
See you later.